What's the Matter with Helen has to be one of my favourite Debbie Reynolds films, and unquestionably one of her most underrated, certainly the most underrated towards the middle and end of her career. I say the end, it was 1971. And this film was directed by Curtis Harrington and written by Henry Farrell and stars the fabulous Reynolds and Shelley Winters. And the description from IMDb is as follows. Two middle-aged women move to Hollywood, California after their sons are convicted of a notorious murder and open a dance school for children eager to tap their way to stardom. I realise the grammar in that is quite poor. It sounds like their sons were convicted for murder and open a dance school for children. Honestly, the fact that they're convicted for murder, for the most part, isn't that prominent. It's kind of in the beginning, and then they move to Hollywood and they have this dance school and it's fabulous. We have these children dancing, but also Debbie Reynolds, being the teacher, Adelle, does a lot of demonstrative performances. She's got some amazing costumes. She looks fabulous. She performs fabulously. And Shelley Winters is absolutely brilliant as well. Needless to say, the performances in this are spectacular. They're full of energy. They're full of enthusiasm. But of course, none of this is without problem. And they start to meet a potential, well, he's kind of a suitor, but he's kind of just a friend. He's a very odd character, which in itself makes it a little bit mysterious. And I have to say, I love the way that this character is introduced and then how the narrative progresses from his introduction. It's very, you know, it takes a very sinister turn quite quickly, because obviously it starts quite dark with this, you know, the conviction. And then they go to Hollywood and everything's bright and shiny. And then it flips again. And the thing I love most about this is something I can't really explain, because it's quite a spoiler. Assuming you don't look too deeply into this, is what happens, you know, quite far into it. It's not quite the climax, but there's some beautiful visual images in this, and I honestly think it's absolutely gorgeous. Oh, this is set in the 30s, by the way, as well, which I think just gives it something a little bit extra as well. I think if it was set in the 70s, it might feel a bit too modern, but the fact that it's in the 30s, just, I really like it. It was also nominated for the Best Costume Design Oscar, which, as I said, the costumes are fabulous. The child actors are really good. We have some really pushy parents and, you know, some parents of kids who really don't want to be there. It's just, it's absolutely brilliant. And as I said, it just feels really underrated. I don't know anybody who's seen it. Obviously, people have seen it. It's got 1,500 reviews on IMDb, which is not an amazing amount, but it's, you know, it's fairly decent. And with a total score of 6.4 out of 10. So it seems to be pretty well received, but personally, it's one of my favourite Debbie Reynolds films. If you get the chance to watch it, please do. I promise you won't be disappointed.